Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video, and thank you for checking out some of my videos. In this video, we'll go back and revisit the sky replacement videos. I did a couple of those, but someone asked me, how would you do that if there were movements on your shot? And in today's video, we are going to have a look just on how to do that. So without further ado, let's go to the editing suite. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are back in DaVinci Resolve, and the first thing we need to do is, of course, we need to do a new Fusion compound clip. But first off, we just have our two clips. Here we have a sky, a photo. It's not a very good photo. It was what I just had. So if you have something better, that would be great. Okay, so first off, just right click here, and then we'll just do a new Fusion clip. And then we'll just go to Fusion. And here we are in Fusion, and the first thing we'll see is that they are the wrong way. So if we highlight everything and push Control T, you can invert the layers. And if you keep the selection and hit F2, we can then rename the layers. The first one will be Merge, and the second layer will be the Sky layer. And then the media in here would just be the House layer, I guess. So that's just one way to rename everything, just by keeping everything highlighted. Okay, so let's just get further away and just rearrange a bit here. Okay, so first thing we need to do is, we need to, of course, again, let's go Control Space and let's find the Luma here. And there we are, that's Luma gear. Okay, I'll just add that. And now that is totally messy and doesn't look good at all. So first thing we need to do is we need to invert that. And then we go up to the sliders we have here, and we want to make it look a little bit better so we can see the clouds in the house and stuff like that. So we'll just adjust it a bit. For this tutorial, okay, fine enough. And as you'll see, if we play the clip now, that's not good at all, because the clouds aren't moving. So we need to track our shot. Again, we'll just one little thing that bugged me a little bit. Okay, and then we'll just continue. first off, we'll just be with the Luma gear selected, Control Space, and then we'll just write planar tracker, and we'll add the planar tracker here. And then let's go into the beginning of the clip, and then in the tracker we are going to change that to hyperpoint area, because we want to track a certain area. And for the motion type, we are going to take translation, rotation, and scale. You can change it for whatever you need, but for this we need that. And then make sure that this pen is selected, and then we'll just draw a area which will be in the shot the whole time, and this was a big area, but, and then we'll just track that forward like so. Okay, we'll just go to the beginning here, and then let's try to go through that. So as you see, the sky isn't moving yet, so we are going to use this by creating a planar tracker transform, and then click that and push down shift and let it go in between the sky and the merge one. And now we have another issue, because the picture is too small. So I'll add a transform node here. And in the transform node, I'll just scale this up, move it a bit. Let's see if that's good enough. And of course, I need to go to the end here and do the scale again, so it will scale the whole image. So yeah, so it isn't the best picture in the world. Actually, I would recommend, if you had the time, to actually make some sky plates when you want to do these kinds of things. And it will also be good so you can have different clouds and different sky replacements of your own that you can use. So I didn't have that. That's just what I recommend you to do, because this photo isn't the best, but This is just the technique of how to do this anyway. So we can just, again, we could try to make it look better, but it is not the best picture in the world. Okay. So here we have the tracking done, and it's applied to the sky layer. So if we want to do some kind of a color grading, because these are two different layers and we want them to match something, we could just do a little bit of color grading inside of Fusion. I'll just again take the planar tracker off because we don't need that one anymore. And then I'll just reconnect yet again. Okay, so let's go to the color with the Luma key here selected, and then just drag the color node down here. And then let's see what we can do. Okay, let's give it a bit of a saturation. And let's do some contrast. And a little with the gain. And then something with the lift. And the gamma just a bit. And the brightness, a little less, a bit more. Yeah. I mean, I'm totally more familiar doing colors inside of the color tab, but okay. And then we could do the same thing to the sky layer. And again, just drag down that color. And then we have another corrector, and I'll just give it some saturation, a little less, something. Okay, and then a little contrasty, something with the gain, and then the lift. And then I'll just drag the colors towards a blue, not too much, something like that. Yeah, something like that. And that's how you do that. So here we have a look at the finished clip. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.